get one thing clear, Rich.
What's that, Tony?
No more rubbish calls.
Whatever you say, mate.
Let me give you the nod before you accept any calls. I don't want any more running on twos and blues to a sweet shop because some kid's lifted a packet of cheese and onion, all right?
It's peanuts, actually.
Sierra 1 from Sierra Oscar, receiving over.
Yeah, go ahead, Sierra Oscar.
Yeah, disturbance, 49 Downs Road, a young girl kicking a door and shouting abuse. Can you deal?
Yeah, we'll run to that, Kev.
What have I just said?
I thought it was a good call.
It's about to be an LOB. It's probably some tart who's locked herself out.
Clear left.
Oh, I'm sorry, you'll have to forgive me. I didn't hear you. It's Tuesday, you see. Tuesday's always hoovering day. I always do it on a Tuesday because Wednesday the bin men come. It's all right. You're not disturbing me. Come in.
Thank you.
Can I get you something?
I'm fine, really.
Oh, it's no trouble.
I've just come to get some details, Mrs. Brown.
Listen to me, going on, wasting your time. Sit down.
Thank you. No, I assure you, you're not wasting our time. Now, about this couple.
Well, he wore jeans, and he hadn't washed his hair.
How old?
Maybe 30, but no older. His girlfriend was younger.
And they said they were from the charity People in Peril?
Yes. They had the stickers, they had the box, the lot.
Any proof of identity on them?
Well, yes, they did show me something, but it was so quick, I didn't have time to get my glasses on.
So you couldn't say whether the ID was bogus or not?
Well, this is the thing, you see. I thought about it afterwards. When the charity people usually come round here, they always show you their pass thingies first, don't they? Well, they wear them like a necklace or a badge, but not these two. That's why I phoned you.
No, you did the right thing, Mrs. Brown.
And then, calling me names because I refused to give them any money. Well, that's not right, is it? Now then, about that tea.
No, I'm fine, really.
Nonsense. It's good community relations.
Mom! I know you're in there! Mom! Mom! I'll kick this door and I will!
Oh, no, you won't.
Oh, brilliant! Thanks, Mum. Thank you very much.
Would you like to tell us what's been going on?
Ask her. She's the one who called you.
We're asking you.
Look, it doesn't matter, does it? All I want's me clothes. She won't let me in to get them.
Well, if you will go around trying to smash doors down, you can't blame your mother for not letting you in.
I wouldn't have to smash the blooming door if you'd let me in.
You got a social worker, Lauren?
What do you think I am?
What's your mum's name?
Carrie.
No, her surname.
Harwood.
Mrs. Harwood! Police, Mrs. Harwood! We've got your daughter out here.
She's in there, I know she is.
Can she come in and collect her clothes, Mrs. Harwood?
Nothing.
Can't you kick the door in or something?
Who do you think we are, the fire brigade?
Are you staying with friends?
Yeah.
Well, look. The only thing I can suggest is that you go away and hope that your mum calms down enough to let you come back and collect your clothes later.
In the meantime, we're going to have to ask you to move on.
Move on?
I can't leave you here.
But I ain't had a change of knickers in 2 days.
Yeah, well, I'd love to help you out, you know, but as I say.
Yeah, yeah, thanks for nothing.
You dirty...
What?
Jailbait.
I feel sorry for the girl. What do you want to go and do a thing like that for?
Ever considered bowling for England?
Stupid cow! Look what you've done! You'll damn well pay for
whoa,
that.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Come on then! Won't be the first time, will you? Kill her,
oh, yeah, oh, us all
calm down, shall we?
See what I have to put up with! See what she's like!
I'm your mother! You should have some respect! I want her arrested just now!
All I want is me clothes, Mum! That's all I want, me clothes!
Let go!
Go! Right! You are Nick! Assault on police!
You can't hit my mum!
Get that, sir, you fat pig! You're hurting me! I'll get your number and report you!
Mum!
It's all your fault, you silly bitch!
You called him, didn't you?
You were smashing the door down!
Assistance required, Norica! Two stroppy prisoners!
You give us your location, Tony. We're on our way.
Me now! 49 Downs Road! Sounds like you got your hands a bit full there, Tony.
Don't hang about, Steve!
No, go on,
calm down!
Right. Well, thank you very much for your help, Joan. You've been most informative. And thank you for the tea.
Oh, there was another thing. They didn't try next door.
How do you mean?
Well, you'd expect them to, wouldn't you? If they were legitimate, I mean.
Yes, I suppose you would.
They got into a car. I watched them. They were arguing, going at it hammer and tongs.
What sort of car?
Blue.
Blue?
One of these long ones, like that.
Estate?
But that's it. The number was VH something, and it had a 3 in it, and it ended with a W.
Wish we had more like you, Mrs. Brown. Thank you very much.
I only hope I haven't wasted your time.
No, not at all. You take care now. Dear Oscar from 9-2, you're receiving?
Go ahead, Sarge.
Kath, will you look up the address of a local charity, People in Peril? I think this one's worth looking into.
Right, which is the violet one?
How do you want to do this?
Youngest in the car.
All right, Marika in the back with her. This one might give you some trouble.
What's your name, love?
Lauren.
What you been nicked for?
I don't know.
Hold your head. Sit.
I hate fighting with Doris's.
I thought you were used to it, Tom.
She's ruined my hat. Only just got this one as well.
Driven with damage, Rich.
Good morning. Do you work with People in Peril?
Yeah.
Can I have a word?
Yeah. Better come in.
This is silly when you think about it, innit? I mean, you, young woman like yourself, getting arrested, and for what?
She blames me for everything. She's always on about something or another. I can't do nothing right.
No.
We raise money through the usual modes of fundraising. Things like poetry recitals.
Do door knocking?
No. Personally, I don't agree with it.
But you have street collections, shopping precincts and such?
Yes, but we have a policy to respect people's space. No aggressive tin rattling or that sort of thing.
But could one or two of your collectors be a little overzealous? Do a little bit of door knocking on their own initiative?
I find that unlikely, officer.
But possible?
Well, we only have about 15 volunteers, all known to me personally.
And what sort of people do you help?
As the name would imply, anyone who's in peril. You see, most charities ford a narrow stream. Children, the old, the starving. We aim to catch the people who don't fall so readily into easily defined groups.
In other words, everyone and anyone?
Well, not quite. We limit applications to confines of the borough.
Is this one of yours?
Yeah.
Well, we're looking for a bloke of about 25, 35, dirty hair, unshaven, could be driving a W-registered blue estate. Ring any bells?
Not immediately.
Do you know if anyone's got a grudge against the charity?
Well, we do have a nasty letters file. Sometimes people are less than understanding when you can't offer them aid.
Could I hang on to those for a few days?
As long as we get them back.
Cheers. And where do you get your stickers printed?
A place down on the industrial estate. Charlie Basham's?
Blokes fancy her, don't they?
Sorry.
Lauren.
She's a kid.
Good-looking kid.
I'm a police officer.
They do. They fancied me when I was her age. I still look young, though. Most people think we're sisters. But all the fellas go for her. Young, you see.
Locked up for a steam, mate. She's gone weird on me.
Hello.
Better? Hear ourselves think now. What can I do for you? A couple of posters for the policeman's ball?
I wish you could. Now, I've come about this.
Well, what about it?
Is this one of yours?
Yeah, it's one of ours, all right. I'm surprised to see it, though.
Why's that?
Well, you probably wouldn't notice the difference, but if you lay another one alongside this, you'll see that this is a flatter red. This one,
more vibrant. Oh, yeah, why's that?
Well, quality fault. If you don't give the ink time to run up, you get a pink instead of a red. You binned a load of them. I didn't want to supply half the old with half the new. It don't look good.
And this could have come from that bag?
Oh, could have.
It's her you should be dealing with, not me. I'm the victim here.
Look, if you don't shut up and calm down, you'll go to a cell now.
Oh, that's right. You side with her, just like all the others. Think with your blooming hormones.
Right, that's it. Cell number one. We'll deal with you later. Come on.
I take it there's no dad on the scene.
There's Mark.
Your mum's boyfriend. Well, you don't get on.
No, he's all right.
Well, what's the problem then?
He's 19. You see, my mum's paranoid. She thinks she's old, but she ain't. So she likes Mark because he makes her feel young.
And having a daughter your age shatters her illusion.
Eh?
Well, in short, you make her feel old.
In short, she reckons I'm bunking up with Mark.
Bit cranked, isn't it?
Yeah, you get used to it.
Tell me, what about your employees?
Sorry?
Are they trustworthy?
We're a small family-run business. The old boy's my uncle, the young one's my son. The other one's been with me years.
Business good?
We get by.
Had to lay anybody off lately?
Funny you should say that. I did have a few redundancies forced on me.
Was that for economic or other reasons?
Do you see any green shoots of recovery around here?
So what about these people you had to lay off?
The young apprentice just off his YTS and another lad been with me 5 years.
And would they have had access to these charity stickers?
Yeah, but they wouldn't be any use to anyone.
Was one of them adverse to shampoo and shaving cream?
Ha! Sounds like Sudsy.
Sudsy?
Steve Chamberlain, the bloke used to take the Michael out of him. He's not got himself involved in anything, has he?
Depends. You know what kind of motor he drives, do you?
Ford Escort Estate, why?
Blue?
When he washes it, yeah.
And would you say he was trustworthy?
Ha! With everything but a bar of soap, yes.
You got an address?
Well, it looks like your mother wants to charge you with criminal damage. No, we never were with her. Well, that still leaves a little matter of assault.
Stupid, weren't I?
She's ruined my hat, son.
So because your mum doesn't want to lose her toy boy, she's chucked you out?
He ain't her toy boy. She's only 33.
And before this Mark, everything was rosy, was it?
It was all right, yeah.
Any chance you can patch up your differences?
Ask her. She chucked me out.
Well, in the meantime, you got somewhere to stay the night?
Like a friend's floor, you see?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, it's not a long-term solution. I mean, a friend in need is a friend most people can do without, right?
I ain't looking for charity. I don't want no one feeling sorry for me or nothing. I've always done my bit, and if I'm in the way, I'll move on. I know when I'm not wanted.
Plenty of practice, huh?
Look, she ain't a bad mum. I mean, you might not think it, but, like, I see her as my big sister, really.
Oh, and all sisters argue, right?
Yeah.
Especially about boyfriends.
Well, you've been informed and given a copy of your rights. You don't want a solicitor, but if you change your mind, let us know and we'll contact a solicitor of your choice.
What about me stuff?
You can keep it. Sign there. OK. We're going to have to lock you up for now until we decide what to do with you. And I suggest, Lauren, you take the time to figure out a way of healing this rift between you and your mother. Swallowing a little bit of prize betting being out in the street, innit?
I suppose.
This way.
What do you reckon?
Well, it's only cautionable. Much as you value your tip for Reg, it's hardly going to impress the CPS, is it?
Yeah, well, I don't think either of us wanted to nick themselves.
I'll be in favour of giving both a caution.
Yeah, me and all.
Yeah, but still a matter of criminal damage.
Won't get to court.
Mum doesn't know that.
How about if we made a big deal of the caution? You know, up the drama a bit. Made it seem like assaulting a policeman was an hanging offence.
Should be.
We might just be able to appeal to the lighter side of her nature.
That's worth a try, Reg. Worth a try.
That number you wanted me to trace through Goley, Sarge, comes up as only one possible on a blue Ford Escort Estate. No registered keeper since March of last year. The full number is Victor November Hotel 319 Whiskey.
Thanks. Circulation to all units. Attention requested to a blue Ford Escort estate. Victor November Hotel.
319 Whiskey. The driver is likely to be a Stephen Chamberlain, concerned in a deception.
Wanted on a warrant and is a disqual.
What's the warrant for, Sarge?
Failing to appear. What's your location, Narika?
Top end of the high street.
I'm sitting up outside the suspect's address in Hallings Road. Any chance of you making it over here?
Where do you want us, Sarge?
Just in the area will do fine, Steve.
Come on, out.
Cheers, Robbie. So, Carrie. You prefer it if I called you Carrie, wouldn't you?
Don't mind.
Are you working?
Perfume counter at the department store.
Thought you smelt nice. So what are you doing here, Carrie?
Ask him, he arrested me.
You've not been arrested before, have you?
No.
No. And now here you are, sitting opposite me, having assaulted a police officer. It disappoints me.
Sorry?
It disappoints me to see an attractive young lady making a mess of her life.
What do you mean?
Well, first of all, there's a criminal record. And how are your employer's going to take it when you take a day off work to go to court? It's hardly jury service, is it?
They couldn't sack me or anything, could they?
Well, they're not supposed to.
They'll be watching, you know, won't they?
Yeah, just wait me an excuse.
It's an employer's market.
And then there's Lauren.
She's got to you, hasn't she? She's got to you.
Look, Carrie, she's a nice young girl. Bit quick-tempered, maybe, but who did she get that from?
She's not the little angel you lot think she is.
I'm sure she isn't. But then we're not going to chuck her out on the street, are we?
So what's your side of the story, Carrie?
OK. We go out together, Lauren and me, to nightclubs and stuff. We might get off with a couple of blokes. Don't let on that we're mother and daughter. I met Mark. We both fancied him. Only he came up to me first. Asked me to dance.
Now he's living with you.
I love the bloke. Is there anything wrong with that? So what would you do if you came back and found your daughter in bed with a man you love?
You found them in bed together?
Not exactly.
Well, what were they doing?
What do you think?
Well, they might not have been, you know.
Of course they were.
Look, all I'm saying is, in a situation like that, well, you always think the worst, don't you? Look, I'm not being naive, but, well, kids experiment, don't they?
The kind of experimentation they were up to led me to have Lauren in the first place.
Sierra Oscar 2 from 9-2, are you receiving?
Go ahead.
Blue Escort has just pulled up in Hallings Road. Are you available?
Yeah.
It's facing south towards Capstan Road. If you sit up on Capstan, I'll keep you informed.
Well, you leave us no choice, Carrie. If you want to pursue this criminal damage to the court, we have to pursue the assault charges. You can't have one without the other.
If she hadn't smashed that window, I wouldn't be here now.
If you'd let her in to collect her clothes, she wouldn't have had to smash the window.
But I am here, aren't I? I'm under arrest.
Yeah, but you can go home now, with a caution. If you drop the charges against Lauren.
And if you let her in to collect her clothes.
It's up to you.
The car's heading south down Hallings Road. I'm following. Stand by to cut it off at the junction.
Understood.
Right, go, go, go!
Anything wrong, officer?
Why didn't you stop back there?
Oh, was that you? I didn't notice.
You haven't got any mirrors?
No, but it's the sun. The sun got in my eyes.
Yeah. Well, I have reason to believe that you have both been trying to obtain money by deception. Have a look in that bag, please, miss.
Don't you have to have a warrant?
Reasonable grounds, bag. And out of the car. And are you Stephen Chamberlain?
Yeah.
We're going to have to go and have a look in your flat, aren't we?
Right, get them both in the van.
Come on.
Right then, young lady. Seems common sense has prevailed. Do you want to go home and get your clothes?
I haven't got home, have I?
Must be some bloke, this. What's his name?
Mark.
Mark? Bit of a catch, is he?
Nah, he's just a bloke.
Not to your mummy, ain't?
To tell the truth, I think he's a bit immature.
Oh, yeah. Come on, then. Time to swallow your pride. Your mum's agreed to let you go home and get your clothes.
Thanks.
Come on in. Carriage awaits.
Well, son?
Well, what?
Well, what did you find out about the boyfriend?
Looking for some tips, are we, Reg?
No, Sergeant. Didn't say no, would you?
Forget it. He's probably out of our league.
Yeah, but don't bear thinking about it, does it? Mother and daughter.
Reg, area car, now.
We've got a mortgage on this place. Kept up the payments fine till I was made redundant.
We wanted to start a family, have kids and that.
Now we're stuffed.
They decided to rip off a charity instead.
It's not a question of ripping off, it's a question of self-help.
It's against the law.
We're in need. We're just cutting out the middleman, that's all it was.
Was it?
Yes. I wrote to Cruikshank. He's supposed to help people in our situation, local. But he wouldn't help. I used to deliver the labels to him and everything. It shows you where his principles are, doesn't it? Some people have got no sense of propriety, have they?
No.
You did the sensible thing, Mrs. Harwood.
Mum, I like Mark, but there's nothing in it, honest.
Look, Lauren, why don't you go in and get your things, eh? I'll wait out here for you.
Yeah. No, no need. She won't be going. Not unless you want to go. No. Need someone to do the washing up, don't I? Oh, Mark!
And where the hell have you been? I've been worried sick.
Oh, don't give me a row, sweetheart. I've had a terrible day.
You see the state of that? Wonder what they see in him. Still, no account in the taste.
Hope for you yet, Rich.